Okay.
Can
here?
You come in?
Sure.
She's worked up, and I told her about you. You've been here before. She
Are you okay? What's your name?
Jordan.
Jordan? Jordan, well, let me tell you, I'm really sorry, and I did not mean to scare you at all. I didn't, okay? I never wanted to hurt you, anything like that. Your dad scared me a little bit when he kind of took off the way he did, okay? And I don't want you to get hurt. I don't want anybody else to get hurt. There's a golf cart on the side of the road. I don't want them to get hurt because he's driving kind of crazy. Oh, it's okay.
Simba, come on.
I have a big old dog, too. It's fine. Okay, so I'm sorry. I'm sorry that the situation kind of happened. Okay?
And do you know, like, what's going to happen?
You want me to be honest with you? So your dad's going to get some tickets, okay? And he's going to have to go to jail for today. He'll have a bond, so he'll be able to get out. And he'll talk to the judge in the morning, and then he'll be able to come home. Or if you bond him out, he'll have a bond.
Yeah.
It's kind of a family matter at that point what everybody decides to do. But he's going to get charges because he ran from me. Okay? So that's kind of where we're at.
My concern is him getting some real help for having made a stupid decision, right? Is there anything that we can do on that order?
So he can do some things to help him.
He can.
You understand what I'm saying? So the judge doesn't want us locking up a million people. They don't want us arresting people. I mean, obviously, if people need to be arrested, they need to be arrested. Right. But if he's already apologized to me,
yeah.
I told him he doesn't really need to apologize to me. He needs to apologize to you because he put you in a very bad position. And that's not a position that you're 14. That's not a position that any 14-year-old ever needs to be in. Okay? So if he talks to the judge and say, "Judge, I need help."
That's where it's
going. He has to start with it. Now you as the family, you can kind of petition for it. But if he doesn't want it, the judge is going to be like, "The heck with you, I don't care."
Yeah.
You know?
Because last time we were here, we talked about ex parte.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Is he still on and off?
Yes. Yeah, so he's, you know, what was it? Probably maybe June when you were here.
Mm-hmm.
Something like that. Maybe earlier. Yeah, it's been a serious effort on his part. Very serious effort.
He can ask. You can ask as well.
But now he's at a point where he's into these different things with spiritual guidance and tarot card readers and other things that are entering into the picture. And you can tell he's smart.
Mm-hmm.
He's smart. You know?
So well, part of the issue is what happens when you use drugs is that, especially some of the drugs that he was using, they can start to affect your brain.
Yeah.
So a lot of people that might have some mental illness, and it could be because they just have mental illness, or it could just be because they were using drugs.
Yeah.
They dive into religion.
Yeah,
it's a common theme.
Yeah.
Okay? I don't know if that's going to hurt, help.
Yeah.
I don't know. You can ask for mental help, but has he been diagnosed with anything?
Yeah. Right, that's what I'm
It's going to be
for.
It's going to be hard if he doesn't want the help.
Right.
If he asks for it, he'll get it.
He will.
100%. They will 100% give him the help if he wants it. But he has to want it.
Yeah, I get that.
Okay.
I had a friend of mine years ago when I was a kid, 18 years old, that he was a heroin addict. And he told me, he said, "The rehab is not it."
It doesn't help unless
you want it. Yeah.
And he has to kind of
want it.
He has to ask. If he asks for mental help, he'll get mental health help.
Yeah.
If he asks for treatment help, he'll get treatment help. But he has to kind of ask. And you can ask, but at this point, we're kind of in a rock and a hard place because they'll say, "Well, yeah, your family wants you to get help. Your family sees a problem."
Right. So that puts me in the dilemma.
Mm-hmm.
Do I let him stay there or do I let him out?
That's completely up to you. I cannot give you that answer.
Yeah.
I cannot.
But I know if I just leave him there He doesn't ask for help, it's not going to happen. But on the other hand, if I leave him there long enough, he might.
He'll go to first appearance tomorrow. Oh. He'll, what's today? He'll go at 1:30 tomorrow afternoon.
Right.
He will go to first appearance. You can go to first appearance and tell the judge, judge, he has some issues. He needs help. It's only the first appearance, so they're just here to see if I have probable cause to pull him over, if everything on my end was good. And then they go from there. But he'll have more arraignments, you know, and you can speak to when he gets a public defender. You can speak, or if you guys want to pay for a lawyer, you can speak to the public defender about getting him help. But, I mean, a whole nother layer to this that you guys probably aren't even thinking about. She's 14. She's a juvenile. DCF is going to be involved.
Will it?
Absolutely. I have to send my report to DCF.
Okay.
Because he did that with her in the car.
Right.
So, it escalates things.
Right.
Like I said, I don't know if you heard me. I know you were crying. If he had just pulled over, we would have called Grandpa to come get you guys. None of this would have happened. Our actions have consequences,
yeah.
You know? And I asked him if you had a phone, if you guys were scared, if you didn't think that I was the real police, you could have called 911 and said, hey, I think somebody's trying to pull me over. And they would have been able to see that I had called out and said, hey, this car is fleeing from me.
Yeah,
you know, yeah. It's just bad decisions. And your dad's okay. He's completely fine. He's upset. But that's kind of where we're at. Okay?
All right.
Do you have any questions?
No, how long is he in jail for?
So, how it normally works is somebody goes to first appearance. So, they get arrested, right? Depending on what day it is, they have first appearance. Today is... It's already... 226. So he's going to miss first appearance for today, but he'll go to first appearance tomorrow. So the judge can say, you know what? I find that there is probable cause that I had a reason to stop him. And then the judge could say, we're going to let him go on his own recognizance. He can go back home. Or the judge can say, we're going to keep your bond. If you bond out, you're good to go. Or the judge can say, absolutely not, you have no bond. I don't think the judge will say that he won't have a bond. I think he's going to keep his bond that I give him. And then if somebody wanted to bond him out or if he could bond himself out, then he'll be able to get out of jail. And that's why I said before it's kind of a family matter that, you know, you guys might be able to, he might be able to bond himself out. Anything like that. There's different options.
What if he can't?
If he can't, he'll stay in jail for 2 weeks, and then he'll see another judge. And that judge will decide if the bond is reasonable, if they should let him out while he's waiting for trial, or if he needs to stay. It's kind of up to the judge. I don't really have anything to do with how long he's there. Okay, it kind of all depends on family situations, if he has his own money, if he has anything else that he can put in place of the money. For example, I own a house, so I can say I'll put my house down as collateral.
He has assets.
So he might be able to talk to a bondsman and get out that way. It's up to him. But now what happens if he doesn't show up to court is that bondsman can take all of that collateral. So let's say he puts his car up and says, hey, I'm going to put my car up as collateral for me getting out of jail. If he doesn't show up for court, the bondsman can come and take his car. You understand? So it's kind of up to you guys.
Yeah.
You guys have several options. Okay?
So DCF will be advised?
Yes.
Right? Is there any possibility they'll intervene here?
I don't know what they're going to find. I don't know their situation. I don't know anything. If anything, does your dad have custody of you?
Yeah.
If anything, they might give you custody just to keep her here.
Yeah.
I have no clue. There's nothing like drug involved or anything like that.
Right.
So I don't think.
Okay. All right.
Anything like that. I think it'll be pretty cut and dry. He just made a silly decision. He needs to handle it. But you're still
excellent.
Good here. Excellent. Okay?
All right, babe.
Do you have any more questions? Are you sure? Okay. Do you want to come talk to him real fast? Are you okay? Yeah, he's sitting in my car.
You
want
to talk to him?
Yeah. Come on. I have no problem letting that happen. Did he give you anything? No, he was just driving. Hey, Sixie, I'm coming out right now.
Yeah,
you can. No, I have his phone. He wants his phone. You could turn the car off, though.
Okay.
And then I really came in there to get you just to tell you, hey, we're about to get out of here and leave. But if you have questions, then we have questions. Yeah, that's okay. Come around here. He's right in that white car over there. She had questions. She was crying hysterically, so I was trying to answer all the questions. Talked all about the bomb. She knows everything. Okay? All right.
You all right? I know. You got your pressures on?
They might be in my pocket.
No, we took... They should have searched it and took all of your stuff. Let's see. Here you go. Do you want any of this stuff to go with him?
All of it, yeah.
All of it? Your phone, lighter, there's a knife, a dollar, and your glasses. Okay. There you
Thanks
go.
Very much.
Not a problem.
Sorry, man.
Sorry.
I got scared. Me and Anna in 2010 were getting pulled over by an unmarked car. You can ask your mom about it. Well,
Well,
it's all right. She was here once. She remembers you.
I know, but that wasn't a good
situation. That wasn't the best situation.
Yeah.
So.
It was actually better than this.
Well.
All right.
Okay, we're going to get going. I just want to make sure if you want to say anything and if you have any questions.
You're going to have your first appearance tomorrow. So, like in the afternoon, I won't be there because of Jaden. I got to get Jaden from school. So later that night, we'll see whatever's going to work out. My concern, you know, anything.
Get with Betty. Betty will come get me.
Betty?
Yeah, give her the
David.
He'll have access to a phone.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, David's mom.
Yeah.
You have her number? It's in my phone.
All right.
Betty Newberry.
I don't know how to get in your phone.
I changed the password to 2013.
Okay. All right. She's been very
cool. Heard me? Jaden's birthday, 2013.
Yeah.
Betty's like, she's like my mom. All
right.
So, yeah, like, just give her the cash or whatever, and I'll pay you back.
Whatever. Let's also try to turn this into an opportunity for any other help that you might want. You know, if it's the drug thing, I know you put on your own.
Drug thing. It's this whole thing that's against me is going to come to light now, I believe, because of this.
All right.
I believe that.
All
right. Okay.
And it's not your fault at all. I get that.
No,
it's not at all your fault.
Look, I appreciate it.
I was just scared.
I understand. All right. I appreciate it. We're going to get out of here. Okay? Right.
Okay. We'll see you later.
All right. Get with Betty so she can come get me as soon as possible.
Either that or I'll keep Jake home.
Well, I might get a bond today, maybe.
Say that one more time.
What do you have to say?
Give me just a second.
Okay.
All right.
I know, you can call, right? You'll be
able to get a bond today?
You're going to have a bond today. Yeah, okay.
So what's that? Yeah, you're still on. Let's get out of here.
Okay. You're gonna have a bond. Okay. You'll be able to call him when you get there. I'll make sure you know your bond, and then you can call him, okay?
I love you.
All right.
Bye.
All right, bye-bye.
Thank you.
Not a problem.
You could have made this horrible.
No, you're good. You're good. I know.
You get better. You're my good person.
I appreciate that. No, I'm not just trying to. It happens, man. It happens. Right. I understand. Hold on one second, okay? What motor 62 Central? Can you copy transport? Can you copy a transport? I'll be going to District 6 with my 1015 adult male. Last 3812.
Okay, I was almost wrong. But then I thought about the time back in 2010. I was familiar with, like, what if she's not? You know? And I was thinking, I didn't know.
Let's go this way.
Makes me sad. That makes me real sad. Well, I hope to meet you one day on way better circumstances than this. You're gonna have to speak a little bit louder because I just can't hear you, okay?
Were you guys able to see that the suspension was in 2011?
I haven't re-looked at everything yet.
Yeah.
So I'm not really sure. I'll tell you as soon as I look at it.
Yeah, when you
okay?
Look at it, you'll see that my license was suspended in 15, and that was the last time I went to jail.
Did you pay everything you needed to pay off?
Yeah, 15. Paid everything.
And you got it reinstated?
Last time I was in trouble at all.
Okay.
Driving on suspended right here.
So what happened?
Picking my son up at school.
Mm-hmm.
And I was driving on suspended. And I paid that off and got my license back.
Okay.
And just recently I got a thing in the mail to pay a fine from 2011 court cost to reinstate, or my license was going to be suspended, which I had paid that off back in 2013 when I got off my probation. And it's like, that's when I was like, well, maybe with this person is telling me. That's why, if you notice, I have amethyst on my chest.
Yep, I saw your amethyst.
I have rose gold under there, and on my hands are all the other crystals.
So I completely understand what you're saying, and I'm not saying that you're wrong. Okay? But something that you need to think about is not everybody has your best interest at heart. So I'm not sure what the spiritualist told you. She could be wrong, and just because she's telling you X, Y, and Z, that doesn't mean that it's true. Okay? So that's just something else that we have to think about, okay? Because like I said, I don't want to meet you like this. I don't like having people in the back of my car. I don't like it. I told you, if you would have pulled over, you would have gotten a citation, and then I would have called your father to come pick you up.
Anonymous concerned citizen calling in about the school zone. diverting traffic
forward. I completely understand. I'm, like I said, I don't want to meet you like this. This is not what I want. No.
He's not.
We left your car there. But you can't be driving. But that's part of the problem. If you weren't driving, your car is expired. And you're suspended.
And again, I lied to you. I'm sorry. But I did tell you the truth right after.
I'm not judging you based off the lie. I'm really not. What I'm judging you on, and what makes me very upset, is that you put your daughter in danger. You understand? You put your daughter in danger.
I do understand.
And that's a problem. Because I don't want any kid. I'm up at the school every day. I do not want any person or child, anybody to get hurt. And by you driving that way, you put your daughter, her life is in danger.
Because
you know what you want to do.
Well, you
don't know what the other people are gonna do.
But I know my.
You know what you want to do.
Well, I know my ability. I'm
you know your ability.
Yeah.
You know what that other person's ability was. Do you know how they drive? Do you know them? Do you know what they were thinking? You don't. You can only hope and think. Oh yeah, they look like they're pulling over. And what if they just decided to go straight? Because I've almost been T-boned multiple times at work.
You know, everybody has different skill sets. Mine is motocross. I'm a driver. I mean, I'm a motocross. And, like, I have, that is my skill. Like, my daughter, I know it looked like she was in danger, but she was not.
But she was, because, listen to me, you don't know what somebody else is going to do. So no matter what you say, and you saying that she wasn't in danger, she absolutely was. You put all three of our lives in danger because you just didn't want to pull over because you were scared. And we would have had this interaction, just like this. We would have had a conversation. You would have gotten a ticket. And then you would have gone home. You understand? Like that.
It's like, you know, yes, I totally understand. And I know that's how exactly, that's a fact. What you said is a fact. And at the time, in my mind, it's that I'm such a phenomenal driver. Because I used to go to the beach when I was a kid.
Okay.
And I would hold my floor. I'd go to 120 miles an hour and get to the beach from my house in 17 minutes every time. About 17, 18 minutes, Daytona Beach. You know, because I'm a phenomenal driver. So it's like, I knew that I was, in my mind, at least, I wasn't going to put her in danger. But I understand that the fact is that it's still dangerous.
Inherently, what you did is dangerous.
Yes.
When you're driving into oncoming traffic, it's dangerous.
Well, they pulled over a little
bit. Doesn't matter. Did you hear what I said? I didn't say anything about another car. What I said was driving the way you did. Driving into oncoming traffic is inherently dangerous. That's what I said.
There was another car coming.
There was another car coming. Just because you think that car slowed down, that does not mean another car was not coming. It does not mean that there was not a car occupying that lane of travel already. Yes, the lane that you were in, and the lane that you went into to get around the other car.
I thought the other lane, I was pretty sure there was not anybody.
Yes, there was. There was a red SUV.
Way back.
No, it was not.
How close was
it? Less than a car length.
I have to see that.
Okay.
I'm not arguing.
No, I don't think you are. What motor 62 Central copy ending?
What motor 62?
814. All right. Come on. Give me just a second. I'm going to open up all the doors, and we'll get you in and get you settled so I can type real fast, and then we'll get you out, okay?
Would I be able to get any water or anything?
Yes, but I have to, the faster I start typing, the faster I can do everything else. Okay, so just give me just a minute. All right, ready? Okay, you come on out. And we're gonna walk straight through that first door, and then we're gonna go to the right. And then we're gonna go right to the middle. Wait, 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 stand up, stand up. Which hand? Turn around, look at me. Which hand do you want free?
My right hand.
Your right hand? Okay, so turn around for me. Perfect.
Thank you. These are very
long. Yeah, they're not supposed to be comfy.
No, I
am. But they have them pretty loose on you.
Yeah, they were not too bad.
Okay, go ahead. Scoot to your right. Perfect. Look at that. Okay? Give me a minute to get settled, get everything going, and then we will get you some water and stuff, okay?
Thank you.
Not a problem. I'll be back in here to check on you in a little bit. All right.